The state of data engineering in 2024. According to the AIM research report from last year, the data engineering market was expected to grow at a compound annual growth rate of 33.8% over the next 5 years, increasing from $29 billion in 2023 to growing at $124 billion by 2028. One of the biggest reasons is generative AI and LLMs. We need to convert the raw data into actionable insight. This video will give you industry overview of data engineers in India, but it also applies to the entire world. We will also talk about the several aspects of data engineering, such as number of jobs available, what are the median salaries provided, company types, attrition rates, how likely you will leave the job or get fired. There are so many different things that you need to understand about data engineering and where this industry is moving. So we will talk about everything about the state of data engineering in 2024. I urge you to watch this video from start to end if you want to understand where this industry is moving. Are you ready? Let's get started. Now, data engineers are primarily responsible for collecting, storing, and analyzing the data. Their main responsibility is to collect data from multiple sources, process all of this data so that data scientists, machine learning engineers can utilize this data to create the value for their company. As more and more people are getting access to the internet, the data is getting generated from various different sensors, stock market, social media platforms, which are generating huge volume of data. And data engineers play a vital role in managing and ensuring the integrity and quality of the data. So in simple terms, data engineers are the people who collect data from multiple sources, process this data as per the business requirement so that data scientists, machine learning engineers, or analysts can understand this data and provide value to the company. Data is often referred as the new oil of 21st century. Leveraging all of these data allows businesses to take the right decisions so that you don't take decisions based on the assumption. You use the data, understand what is going inside the business, and based on that, you take the right decisions in the right direction. The data engineering market is likely to cross 100 billion by 2028, signaling a robust expansion in this field. Let's start by understanding the distribution of data engineers across the non-IT sectors. As you can see, the BFSI sector stands for banking, financial services, and insurance, which traditionally employed large number of data engineers, recorded a decrease in proportion from 52% in 2023 to 49.3% in 2024, the decline of around 2.7%. The 2.7% is a very small number. This reduction is mainly because of the increase in automation and the new tools that are coming in the market. But on the other hand, telecom sector has experienced a remarkable growth in data engineers, with the number increasing from 15% to 27.8% between 2023 and 2024. Now, this growth is largely because of the 5G adoption in India. You need to optimize the entire network. The rate at which the data is getting generated from all of the IoT devices are huge. So you need people who can manage all of these data. Other sectors like pharmaceutical, life science, as well as the retail has seen some reduction in the number of data engineers. Again, this might be because of the recent economic condition, the layoffs that happened across different companies. But as we move forward, the market is likely to recover. Now, if you look at the compensation trends in data engineering, there has been a decrease in data engineers earning between 3 to 6 lakh, dropping from 32% to 17.3% in 2020. Now, this is mainly because of the increase in automation and outsourcing some of the low-skill work. But on the other hand, data engineers earning between 6 to 10 lakhs rose by 8.4% to 32.4% in 2024. Same for the people who are earning between 10 to 15 lakhs, increased by 13.4% to 26.4% in 2024. This means that mid-level engineers who are capable of multitasking, delivering the efficient outcome and providing the stability for the companies, the compensation for these guys are increasing. Companies are paying more to the senior engineers than freshers, but they are also hiring the freshers for a lot of different roles. If you look at the closer look at the experience level of data engineers working in all of these companies, you will see a significant increase in data engineers with 0 to 3 years of experience, which rose from 25% to 29%. People ranging from 3 to 6 years of experience rose from 37% to 44%. And for the people 6 to 10 years experience, which rose from 3% to 18% from 2023 to 2024. This shows that companies require mid-level engineers who can sustain and have the positive impact on overall company's growth, but they are also hiring freshers so that they can train them and retain for the longer period of time. We will understand this part when we talk about the attrition rate of data engineers. Most of the entry-level jobs mainly focuses on the basic data processing and data cleaning. So companies are likely to automate this part. But if you are a fresher data engineer who is properly skilled with the latest tools and the skill set, then the chances of you getting hired by all of these companies increases. Same applies for the people who has more experience from 6 to 10 years or even more than that. These people are at the driving seat. These people are taking decisions. These people are mainly data architects or the people who take decisions for the business where they need to invest their money so that they can find more insightful value from the data. Let's understand this part by understanding employment trends for data engineers across company types. If you look at the IT or IT service company, you will see a decline in data engineers dropping by 17% to 13.7%. Again, this is because of the automation reduction in the workforce. Companies are laying off some of the people because they want to optimize the overall process. But on the other hand, consultancy firms have experienced increasing data engineering roles from 4% to 6.1% in 2024. This growth is driven by an increasing need for data analytics and the consultancy services across different industries. If you look at the captives, GCC or boutique analytics, this basically means product-based companies. They have also seen the significant increase in the share of data engineers. Captive GCC firms almost quadrupled their shares from 2.0% to 7.4% in 2024. Also, for the analytics firm, they tripled their hiring from 2% to 6.8%. These product-based companies really require data engineers because they need people who can understand their domain first and then process their data as per the requirement. Now, this was mainly around different company types. But if you look at the sector-wise growth in data engineering, there has been approximate 7% increase in the number of job openings for data engineers across the country, indicating the healthy growth environment for this field. Even the BFSI sector saw the decline from 50% to 33% in 2024. It still maintains the significant share of data engineering job vacancy because this sector is heavily dependent on the data analytics for functions such as risk management, customer insights, regulatory compliance, and ongoing digital transformation that require data engineers to work on all of these problems. The demand for skilled data engineers, analysts, and scientists will grow in this field. Now, if you look at the other sectors such as pharmaceutical and healthcare sector, it also saw the increase in demand for data engineers, with job openings rising from 15% to 20% in 2024. Main focus of utilizing data analytics is because of the clinical trial, pharmaceutical research, and overall healthcare management has increased the demand. Not only this, internet and e-commerce sectors also saw increase in data engineering job openings from 15% to 18.4%, mainly driven by the online transaction and understanding the need of customer experience. All of these industries mainly rely on data, so you need people who can convert all of this raw data into the actionable insight. Let's talk about the salary trends for the data engineers. Job openings for data engineers earning between 6 to 10 lakhs per annum saw the increase of 1.3% to 31% from 2023 to 2024. This means if you're a mid-level engineer, then your demand is increasing across different sectors. Companies are now recognizing the role of data engineers in the market because, again, most of the companies have their entire data stored across various different data systems. They don't have the proper mechanism to utilize all of this data and convert this data into the valuable insight. But on the other hand, while we saw the growth for the mid-level engineers, there is a decrease in the higher salary brackets, with the 10 to 15 lakhs bracket dropping from 31% to 26% and 15 to 20 lakhs bracket decreasing from 18% to 15%. This basically means companies are being very careful if they want to invest into the higher paying talent. If you look at the data engineer salary by the experience, while entry-level data engineers saw increase in the median salary from 6.2 lakhs to 8.6 lakhs, suggesting a stable growth for the freshers. So based on experienced freshers and the mid-level engineers, salaries is increasing, but there is a decline for the experienced guy who has experience of 10 to 12 years. Saw their median salary decrease from 26.6 lakhs to 18.7 lakhs, and with the people who has more than 12 years of experience, saw the reduction from 32.2 lakhs to 17.2 lakhs. Basically means companies are preferring more freshers and the mid-level engineers and very careful about if they want to invest huge money for the experienced candidate. Again, all of these things are driven by the economic pressure and the rise of automation in the industry. This is not only for the data engineer, this applies to all of the different sectors such as software engineering, data analytics, data science, each and everything. We understood based on the experience, but if you look at it from the sector-wise salary trends, you will understand that there is a decrease in the retail sector. It went from 30.4 lakhs to 13.5 lakhs. That same applies to the media. It went from 27.4 lakhs to 9.6 lakhs. Sectors like retail, travels, and tourism didn't see any effect on this. They were more stable. But IT sector saw the increase from 10.2 lakhs to 13.9 lakhs. Mainly because of the online technological advancement. If you look at the median salary trends for data engineers across company types, you will see product-based companies experience dramatic decrease, median salary dropping from 25.6 lakhs to 10 lakhs. This is huge because Product-based companies are being more careful if they want to invest their money into hiring a data engineer. This is mainly because of the restructuring of the organization, companies realizing that instead of hiring 10 people, we just need 5 people in this space. But on the other hand, domestic firms saw the increase from 11.6 lakhs to 16.1 lakhs. Same goes for the analytics firm. Now, if you live in India and if you want to understand based on the different city, you can just look at this data. You will understand as per the city how the trend changes, so you can take your decision based on that. Now, this was all about the salaries, but let's look at the attrition rate. That basically means how likely you are to leave company as a data engineer or get fired. And this is very important for you because the layoff season happened and you saw a lot of software engineers lost their job, but there were very few data engineers or the people who were working in the data field got affected. And this is what we will understand right now. The attrition rate among data engineers in 2024 compared to 2023 saw a significant decline across all experience levels, suggesting enhancement in the job satisfaction, career development opportunities, and employee-to-employer relationship. Notable decrease in entry-level data engineers having experience from 1 to 2 years, where attrition rate decreased from 35% to 20.4%. The same thing happened for the people who had 3 to 5 years of experience, that went from 28% to 18.6%, with the people having 6 to 10 years of experience also went from 18% to 12.6%. This basically means companies are being very careful and are more rewarding towards the data engineers because they understand the impact they have on the overall company's growth. So whenever they hire data engineers and whenever they train these people, they want to retain all of these people. They retain all of these employees by providing them proper positions, salary increase, and extra bonuses. If you look at the same data as per the different sector, you will see a good improvement. Internet and e-commerce sector saw the attrition rate decline from 25% to 18.66%. IT sector also saw the decline from 19% to 13.38%. Again, companies are realizing the importance of data engineering and they want to retain all of these people. So in conclusion, even though companies are reducing positions for data engineers as per a different sector, they need people who can work for the long period of time so that they can extract value from them. So if you are a data engineer who is working in a company, you are less likely to get fired because companies want to retain you for the longer period of time. Now, this was about the attrition rate, but let's look at the skills required for data engineers as per the different experience level. If you look at this, currently on an average, 29.5% of data engineers across different experience level need these skills such as Python, SQL, understanding about the ETL, extract, transform, load, and the PySpark. You can just look at this graph and you will understand the different skill set required for different experienced people. I'm just going to plug my course that if you want to learn all of these basic skills, you can literally learn all of these skill set just by enrolling into my combo package, Python SQL Data Warehouse and the Spark one. You will learn everything about all of these skill set in just 4 different courses. Data engineers with a 3 to 6 years of experience required understanding the cloud computing platforms such as AWS, Azure, GCP, and data engineers who have more experience from 6 to 10 years or even more need to understand the overall company growth. They can strategize everything and have the understanding about the latest tools such as Snowflake, Databricks, Redshift, and all of the other things. And also you can find the need of data engineering based on the experience level compared to all of the other roles. So let me just summarize this entire thing so that you can understand in simple language, because we saw a lot of data and I wanted to show you all of this data so that you understand first. Now let's try to understand this into simple language. First of all, we saw the job openings. Again, data engineering market is expected to grow across the 100 billion mark by 2028. This is projected. So there will be so much opportunity in this field in the future. And this is the best time if you want to become a data engineer, you can start upskilling yourself. If you start now and after a year or two, you will become a mid-level engineer and you will see the rise in your salary because a lot of companies will want you because they need people who are experienced. So in order to get the experience, you need to start from somewhere. So I highly suggest you to start working on your projects. You can get internship, you can work on the lower pay, just so that you can get the experience and have the higher salary in the future. Also, based on the sector wise, we saw some fluctuations. So some of the industries such as BFSI didn't need data engineers, but on the fundamental level, all of these industries work on the data. So if not right now, they will require people who can manage and process all of these data. Again, the attrition rate has dropped because they understand the need of data expertise across the different companies. In general, data people drive value to the company. They help businesses to move forward. So what is happening inside the company, they try to understand that, and based on that they take the right decision that drives the business growth. They can increase the overall profit and improve the overall customer experience. Again, for data engineers, core skill set is Python, SQL, understanding about the ETL, basics of data warehouse and Apache Spark, which is really important. Again, if you want to learn them, you can just check out my courses. You will find the link in the description. And one more thing is adapting to the new technologies. New tools in the market come and go. AI and LLM has increased the productivity of the people. So if you are someone who is working in this field, then you need to understand how to utilize these AI tools in your day-to-day work environment and produce more outings that used to take 2 days. You can complete all of these things within few hours. If you are an engineer working in the IT field, that you need to understand how to produce more output in the short amount of time. This was everything about the state of the data engineering. This report is submitted by the Analytics India magazine. So if you want to learn and understand this complete report by yourself, I will put the link in the description so you can go and read the complete report. I summarized the entire thing in this video, but if you want to learn by yourself, then you can go and read that report in detail. This was everything from this video. I hope you understood something and learned something new. If you did, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Let me know if you want to see these types of videos in the future or not. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.